our joining is so... it's really holy. To come together and... remember the presence of who we are. It has nothing to do with the form of the characters. And so, you know, just to honor the presence that's here now, and it's in each of us. And the mind and the heart is so open to all brothers and sisters, no matter how it seems to play out and form. The mind and the heart is so open. And when I was feeling into the love this morning, it's a love not of this world. It's a love that we cannot put a definition to. But it is a love that stands in its pure glory and brilliant light and will melt away everything that is not of it. And I feel so very humbled. Because it seemed like the journey was a separate journey, a journey of isolation. But to come with mighty companions that have the desire to join and connect, to remember the truth. All I can say is it just really feels exuberant, dazzling, expansive, and the extension of it just wants to pop. The Course says God's will for us is perfect happiness. And God loves us so much that His will for us is perfect happiness. And sometimes the mind distorts that because of its ideas about God. But the God is the magnitude of who we all are, sharing that one mind of majesty and grace. And when we come together with such purpose, the little me cannot hold up in such face of love. And sometimes it wants to rattle the things because it's feeling like it's losing ground. But the littleness is losing ground so that we can come into the glory and the magnitude of who we are. And so when I seem to look insane, when I'm going through a healing, and a brother comes up to me and shares a little act of kindness, it's very beautiful. Because I know it's coming up and it might look insane only because it's part of the healing. When I turn and look and someone smiles or touches my hand or shows those little gentle acts of kindness, it's a reminder, oh, I am innocent, I'm okay. Where this world seems to be a world of guilt and blame, and it's not true, none of that, that's an old story, it's dropping quickly, it just doesn't serve, and yeah, I at one point the mind got blown and it connected to all its parts and it was a mystical experience for me. And now what's happening is everybody's showing up in form. Mm. Yeah, that I can actually know I'm one with every seeming part. And it's like, yeah, wow, I didn't know I was so glorious. Today's a celebration. A celebration of remembering. Because when we came to this seeming world, we came in like a flaming comet. Because we made an agreement to forget who we were. But now we're making an agreement together to remember that we are the light of the world. And it so wants to be extended. And the crack in the cosmic egg is way too big to ever look back. So I didn't know what was going to be shared today. I was in prayer last night and this morning, and the word love came in, and there was no rehearsal, no trying to figure out what was going to be said, but Kirsten and I joined together, and it's like in our joining, you know, it's we were both feeling the same things coming through. And so yeah, it's just telepathically, you start really communicating telepathically to the one mind. The words we didn't really need words this morning, although they were used only to show us we were already one. And so I'm just very grateful to have the opportunity to join you, Holy Sister, because I have been one to say I want to collaborate, but have been a little bit afraid to. And now it's like I thought I might be making stained glass somewhere in a shed, but the spirit had a different plan for me. Here I am, and it looks like communication, collaboration. Let it be from the undefined mind, the not thinking mind. And let this urban ministry launch whatever it looks like. I have no idea. But I have a sense that it has to do with everyone here. I'm going to share a reading from our realtor, Dwayne, who occasionally sends me the most glorious channeled messages from God. And this one is called Guidance in the Joy of Living. And it's all about love, the four-letter word. Divine encounter teaches me that the foundation of all that is eternal is love. We are drawn unto His presence from within. The essence of our being as we honor all of life with the simple four-letter word love, the creative spiritual foundation of life itself. Since love originates from the reality of who God is in each of us, we must know that we take it upon ourselves to be led by the guidance in the joy of living, and we will find ourselves drawn into the oneness and completeness only found within the eternal relationship with the heart of the Father, far removed, forever removed, from the separation that was a type of spiritual blindness. But now we find ourselves totally complete, in the reality of His present moment, elevated beyond time and space of the cosmos, to an existence with the Father that abides within each of us. Therefore, our lives take on new dimensions. For has He not said, "In my Father's house there are many mansions"? And our lives become one of divine discovery as we listen and hear the Holy Spirit's voice of guidance in the joy of living. Now, we could talk about the mortal taking immortality, but this is a present reality when you love from His perspective, and separation has ceased to be the application and manner of your life, because you choose to allow His divine presence to be one of relationship without separation, and not just a religious function. You must know that without separation, our lives become one of present reality and all-knowing, which give us eternal access to the Holy Spirit's guidance in the joy of living. May your life be fulfilled in the guidance and the joy of living by His present Holy Spirit. I was listening to a talk the other night by Thomas Merton, or based on Thomas Merton's writings in life, and he's a mystic who was deeply touched by the presence of God, and the deeper he went into that, the more he experienced just that divinity in everything, and he would find himself writing poetry about his experiences of that, of the mystical and of oneness. And in one of them he wrote, about experiencing God and divinity, like in the forest and in the trees and in the leaves, and seeing the perfection of everything in its divine order, that there couldn't ever be anything wrong. And yet he wrote, "How could I say that I love the woods?" Because he knew that it was not the woods
He talks about the poverty in all things, and yet there is this divinity that can flow through all things, which is the mind, the divinity of mind. And without that presence of God, it is an experience of poverty. It's an experience of a separate self that feels very little and poor and disconnected. And really, the form is just neutral. It is nothing in and of itself, but the experience of knowing who I am, the experience of that connection with God, just brings the awareness of God is everywhere. Everything is holy. Everywhere is holy because God is in my mind. And that song is coming to me this morning. We'll play it at some point. Everything is holy. And I really love that song because it starts off just talking about, or he's singing about, we used to go to church on Sunday, and listen to the priest. And it was about going to a holy place and listen to holy words from a holy book. But everything is holy now. The mind is opening up to experiencing that the holiness is who I am, and there it's with me always. I mean, I'm here with it, welcoming it, and being willing to just keep forgiving those thoughts and beliefs that say otherwise, that seem to be the veils between myself and the awareness of you, the awareness of who we truly are together. And also in that talk, he was sharing about in coming to the awareness of holiness being everywhere, if the mind is not aware of holiness, which is where, most of us started on the journey, it's like there was no awareness of anything really being holy. We were just doing our best to connect with happiness and joy and love wherever there seemed to be little glimpses of it. And to go from there to total awareness of the perfection and holiness of God is a bit of a A to Z kind of a leap. So it's about opening up to, the Spirit's guidance and really fully embracing what is given and allowing the holiness, like the reverence and the holy purpose for what is given us, to be completely here. Because as we give our mind and we give our heart over to what is given us and really embrace it, we're allowing ourselves to be one with the experience that is given us right now. And being one, being totally present, is our natural state. And from there, it can expand into the awareness of holiness being everywhere. So any symbols that are given us, any tasks that are given us, they all have the potential for us to experience the holiness of ourself and the presence of God within them. Everything does, because we're here. If we're here doing it, then we have the potential to experience God within it. So just the collaboration that Lila was describing this morning, that's really it. And the separate self does have to get dissolved in that. When you come together in oneness with an experience, there is no separation in that. So it can seem safer open up with inanimate experiences or ones that don't seem to have, the potential for the reflections of the unworthiness or the judgment or the no, like people seem to do or have. It can seem much easier to open up with something like music, where all the self, all the judgment is very clearly, obviously, just in one's own mind. Whereas when you open up to it seemingly with another, it can seem more frightening. Because what if she's judging me? It's okay if it's just myself, I can handle that. So it can seem a little scarier to really open up to collaboration. There's such a depth of healing in the opportunities to collaborate, to keep seeing, no, these are just my own thoughts. I truly am loved, and this is just what's arising to be released and healed.
So beautiful, because as we join and collaborate, I can see where the mind, it's just habitual to want to come in and interpret something that this character might be thinking something or judging something, but indeed it has nothing to do with anything outside of my mind. It's the interpretation that's happening in my mind, and what would that do other than to just put a wedge between the real true authentic joining? So to take that interpretation back and go, not that, and to just stay open in the love. Because as soon as I feel my mind interpreting anything of what the eyes are seeing, what the ears are hearing, I can feel the mind wanting to do this. So it takes it from that expansive state. The interpretation takes it from that expansive state and just contracts it. And trusting our purpose together is so beautiful, because I trust the intention of our purpose, that we've all are coming together for this very thing. Is to let wash what will and what does want to reveal itself. And so this is really such a whole and beautiful experience, because I really truly want to know myself in truth. And this is the opportunity, this is the gift extended and given, that the self wants to reveal itself. And it's through our joining that we'll get to see and witness that.
Well, we've been really exploring it a lot at the most recent retreat, and it's like really what this is all about is, you know, to know thyself is to experience oneness, which is equality, you know, perfect equality is in Christ. It's an experience of I know who I am. That's what equality is. The perception that there's another and I want to be equal with another, you know, who is that I who can perceive another they'd want to be equal with? That's like part of just a projection of a belief in equality or a desire to somehow, you know, even things up on the screen.
Bring truth to the illusion.
Bring truth to the illusion. And the only way is to just keep bringing, whenever there's a feeling or a perception of there's someone apart from myself, whether they seem to be above me or below me, if I feel an inequality within myself, of course I'm going to see an outpicturing of it. Like, how could I not, if the world is just reflecting to the beliefs in my mind? And the only way to come back to knowing who I truly am is to pull that back and say, why, like, what is that maintaining truly, like, with absolute sincerity and honesty? Why would I be holding on to a position? Because it brings some kind of safety. And what we find is we keep, like, questioning that, inquiring with that, as it comes back to just really maintaining a sense of a self that knows something, you know, that has a position in the world and knows where it belongs in relation to things, even if it hates it or resents it. At least it's familiar and it's got a position and it's got something to be strong about or with. And what we've been exploring is how really it's a fear of stepping into magnitude, really, is what's behind it. Because when we're willing to really step up and step into the truth of who we are, there's no defenses left. And at first it feels very vulnerable and scary to lay down those defenses. But the more willing we are and the more we keep just saying yes to the opportunities to just keep coming into the collaboration that's beyond the, you know, any sense of a mind that knows something, we do experience this oneness, this one self that's able to be in the flow, just be who it is, you know, extend and give. And you're like, why would, afterwards, when you come through it, it's like, why would I have been holding on to that? So yeah, it's just something we've really been exploring a lot, and the idea of the hierarchy, an external hierarchy. And it's just really a defense against the present moment of saying, and how, you know, what would you have me do? What would you have me step into now to know that I'm one with you? And every time there's a real sincere prayer and an asking, is generally something that's been held back. And if you can get in touch with what you've been afraid of stepping into, or communicating, or bringing forth, it's like, just to act on it, bring it forth, and you're back into the awareness of knowing who you are, knowing who your brother is, full of gratitude. Thank God for mighty companions. God does love me. It's that quick when we're willing to just pierce through the veil, no matter how, you know, much of a wall that veil can seem to be. If it hasn't been pierced through for a long time, it can seem, you know, to be a lot thicker than just a very thin bubble to pop. But forgiveness doesn't take time, that's the good news.
Yeah.
Like, there's no order of difficulty in miracles, no matter how far away from the love we seem to be. It's like all it takes is one miracle and can be back into the awareness again.
It's always in the present moment too. It's like, what is it for now? What is it for now? Because I had a thought that thinking in order to join that I needed to have all this clear first. You know? And like that's like, of course, ridiculous. You know, it's in the joining in the collaboration where I can take responsibility for my mind and come together and join and bring it. My intention is to be in communion with the self, the, you know, the magnitude and the glory, and it's in the collaboration with a seeming other that would bring the stuff up so I could see it in a way, and so that's why we celebrate when things do come up, because it's like, oh yeah, you know, we don't need to hold on to that anymore. That's just a, you know, something that's been barring the way, blocking the way from truth sight.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Woo!
Yeah, it's like that's exhilarating. The ride starts really get exhilarating then, you know. it starts getting exhilarating. I'm feeling the ride of a lifetime, actually.
Okay.
I heard it too.
As soon as that came in, it was that. And it's all undefined, so go for it. You sure?
Yes, there we go.
And these candles are here, by the way, to light. So if anybody feels some movement and would like to light their light, shine their light, just come on up and...
Yeah, as you light your candle, you can just consider maybe leave.
You can light everyone's candles.
Thank you.
It's just an honor, an absolute honor to welcome you to join us as a minister to serve Christ in this way. I know you've been serving Christ for quite some time, but to use the symbol to serve and shine, and you just have such a devoted heart, and we just love you so much, and we're very grateful for you being part of the community. It feels just like another way for you to be able to share and extend and be of service.
Thank you so much. I feel very honored as well to be able to extend and join in this matter. It is an honor. It's absolutely a privilege. And I love that idea of just bring it on. I'm open. I am absolutely open. So I have no idea what this is going to look like, and I haven't got that letter that says this is what it's going to be. This is how it's going to be. And that's okay. And I'm just open and excited. It's just such an honor, and I feel that love as well, and the gratitude is just overwhelming. It's just absolutely a beautiful thing. And I don't know what else to say. Just that I'm open and willing and honored to be a part of this as well. This is just a beautiful extension of the service that I like you say, that I have done for years, but it's just another level, another richness to it. Mm-hmm. So I'm very, very excited. Mm-hmm. Very excited. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely beautiful.
Yay. We're just kind of settling into Camas, and just everything here feels so brand new. It feels, for most of us, like we've never been here before. I guess that's the effect of being in the present moment. And it just feels very sparkly, and it feels like, there's just going to be more of a wave of extension. I know when kind of the monastery first came in, there was like a wave of extension coming down towards Salt Lake. And then a lot more of the extension was coming sort of towards the monastery, and a lot of the focus and energy was there, and it's feeling like a lot more of an extension vibe coming, of going out, and we've been playing, letting the ideas drop in, to do with maybe coming down to Patricia's for gatherings, and coming down, and Doug has a group there with MMT sessions he's been feeling with his group, and Eddie's place. Movie gatherings, and we're opening back up here with Sunday services, and there's musicians here, and there's like a publications team who are just all very sparkly and twinkly, and have all kinds of projects in the wings. And so it really feels like it could be a really sweet winter.
Yes. I was very excited to hear that I was sad when I heard that this was shutting down, that the services were going to stop, because I really look forward to joining with everybody. It's just exciting to see the love and the extension being expressed here. So I'm really grateful to everyone being a part of this, and that this has opened up again. It is exciting, absolutely exciting. It's exciting. I'm honored that I have the ability to join with all this. Absolutely honored. Just exciting stuff. So, yeah. Absolutely beautiful. Beautiful.
Thank you. I feel it.
Feeling that love.
That was, speaking of that feeling, when I got that email from you, and you said, if you feel it. It was this overwhelming feeling that yes, very much feel like joining and being a part of and participating at whatever level Holy Spirit would have me. Mm-hmm. What an exciting thing.
Yeah. And that's it. It's like when your heart, when you really feel it, everything flows from there, you know, and the form can be what it is, because the pressure's not on the form. We don't need the form to be in our function. Really, it's so beautiful to know that, like, I have God. The form can support that and be what it is, but we're not reliant on the world.
I trust.
Functions.
Yes,
yeah.
I trust.
Yeah. We just keep saying yes. With 100% yes, you know, with what it is, and then it just gets revealed.
Very much. So thank you.
Thank you, Dirk. Thanks. We'll finish with this song.
Yes, that feels really good. I feel something wanting to come through about MMT.
Okay. Would you like to come back up?
So we trade places here? Or
yes.
It, speaking of that, it only took me 4 years to go through the 2-year program. So. But, you know, it takes what it takes. After I had finished that 2 years, it changed everything. So I'm glad that I got the opportunity to go back and do the assignment. I think it was at your suggestion. Somebody's suggestion. Anyway, it was a good one. So thank you for that.
Yeah, I'm just so... the experience, just knowing that this part of my mind has stepped through MMT and now I'm going to be extending it.
Mm-hmm.
It's all part of that, you know, the extension. And I guess I'm just coming into such deep gratitude for mystical mind training. Because I'm reminded now, it seems like the mind has gone full circle starting the program before it was actually launched, and stepping through and having such profound experiences where, I mean, I would be flatlined on the floor going, what in the heck? The truth would be so profound, hit me so profoundly that it stunned my mind into stillness, you know? And I realized that having gone through the mystical mind training and then applying it to within the community, watching my thoughts, looking at what they are, I realized that the mind was moving at lightning speed with thought. And then with the mystical mind training program, I was able to surrender the whole mind and let the spirit work with the mind to bring the thoughts back more into slow motion so I could see what was going on in the mind and what wanted to play out and how the character was its little puppet, you know, and do it and it has been such an essential part of the healing process, just to see what's been going on up there, you know? And so I'm just tickled. I am just so tickled because I was joining with you for a while as well with the MMT and there, it just feels so alive in the mind that it's remembering. There's that one scene in the sphere, the movie The Sphere in there where they come together to make an agreement to forget who they are. And then the big silver ball comes up from the bottom of the ocean, goes, oh, they're not ready yet. And then there's a scene where they've all together choosing to remember. And that scene is so powerful. And at that time, I just dropped on the floor in tears going, I don't want to forget. I don't want to forget. You know, and there was a sprinkling of us in Cincinnati at the time, not wanting to forget. And now there's like, I don't know how many symbols of ministers around the globe.
39, I counted them this morning.
Really? So it's like, and you know, it's like, oh my God, the mind's lighting up with this. So I just had to share that because I'm just totally tickled to know that this has really been given. Because I really do, in my heart of hearts, in the knowing of the big no, that this seeming mystical mind training program did not come from a thinking mind. Because when I step through it and I look and I'm really with it, there's no way a thinking mind could have brought it together. So thank you for the open channel, to allow to be the open channel for the extension of such content. And that's what we really want to extend. We want to extend the content to help us awake. If it's not serving the awakening, it can go. You know, so. Yeah. As Lisa would say, I'm done.
The play button at the top of the big remote?
Here?
Yeah, either there or the box.
Miracles, I find it. testament. That'd be very hard to say. Morning outside I stood, I saw a little red-winged bird shining like a burning bush and singing like a scripture verse. It made me want to bow my head. I remember when church let out, how things have changed since then. Everything is holding now. Used to be a world half there, heaven's second rate hand me down, but I walk it with a reverent air, 'cause everything is whole now.
That could be a song, I swear. Mm-hmm.
I could feel a song coming to you.
Beautiful.
Not in this moment, so.
You'll be ready for strawberry.
My holiness.
Yes.
Actually, maybe I won't come in at all. We'll be, because he's going to be there and when I haven't stayed.
No, I'm
not.
Oh,
gonna
you're
going to
have.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Musical chairs.
Chairs.
That's the music.
We're used to it.
Thank you.
Thank you.